When you're hopping onto a new Wayland compositor, especially one outside of GNOME and KDE, it's kind of hard to know what Wayland protocols are actually supported. Now, most of the time, you don't really need to think about it, because most of the time, things just work in the core protocol set. But when you want to do things, maybe not esoteric, but just slightly outside the box, it does really start to matter. If you want a feature like a real working screen locker in cases where it's not built directly into the compositor, EXT screen lock. If you want to have an alternative to the portal video capture method, EXT image capture source and EXT image copy capture is the current solution being pushed. Knowing what protocols are actually supported can, in some cases, be important. Whilst some compositors do go ahead and document them, a lot of the time the documentation isn't up to date, and most of the time the documentation doesn't exist. Yeah, you can dig through the source code and work it out like that if you have any idea where to even begin looking, but nobody really wants to do that. What if there was a better way, a way that could just say, here is the protocol supported, be about your day. Luckily, now and for quite a while, because I forgot to talk about this when it first came out, there is a solution, that being Waycheck. Not only listing protocols that are supported, but those that aren't supported as well, which is very nice because you might just forget a protocol exists in the first place. You're like, wait, was something like single pixel buffer or EXT session lock, was that renamed? Did it move from staging into like another thing? Why is it not supported? So making sure that everything is listed here, even those that aren't in use, is the better way to do this. Now, when I first heard about this app, it was a lot less extensive than it is now. It did have upstream, it did have wroots, it did have KDE. I think Western might have been here, but some of these other categories, these were added since then. Now, due to how upstreaming a Wayland protocol works, there is one additional column that isn't present on any of the other tabs, that being the status. This indicates unstable, staging, or stable. What this means in the context of Wayland protocols isn't really that relevant for today's video, but it is important information to have. So as the name of the protocol, this is the human readable form of the protocol. All of these columns do actually have tooltips as well, so if you're not sure about what any of them mean, that is there to see as well. We have the identifier. This is the internal name used for the protocol, and then the interface version. So basically the version of the protocol that's being implemented. Now in most of the tabs here, name, identifier, and interface version is going to be included. Wroots, KDE, Western, Chrome OS, GameScope. Unknown, we just have interface identifier and interface name. This is more like the catch-all section for things that don't really fit anywhere else. So let's say I want to find something like screen copy, for example. Search for that. It's in Wroots. And there we go. Now, by default, it's going to show every single protocol. But if you just want to search based on things that are actually supported, in this case, we have a KDE Screen Edge V1, or unsupported, you can do that as well. Actually, there was a complete UI rewrite, and I'm kind of thankful I waited to cover it, because honestly, it is a much better application than when it was before the rewrite. Now, when we say Wayland protocol, how we define the edge case for this is a very important question, because whilst the main things are here, the upstream protocols, Wroots, KDE, Western, even Chrome OS stuff, which most Linux compositors don't actually implement, and then GameScope stuff, most of this is only GameScope relevant, there are things outside of this group as well. For example, all of these protocols here, Wayland DRM, AGL Shell, and Virtual Keyboard Unstable. Now, some of these are going to be like older protocols, right? And things just are no longer being supported and things of that nature. But should they still be in the list? Because at this point, none of those that I mentioned are actually present. I had assumed that maybe they would be merged into the unknown category. It probably makes sense to have just a separate category for external, just so you can make sure that all of these are being listed. Because some of the external ones here are in their own separate category, because all the Chrome OS ones, those are now in the Chrome OS sections. So I'm not really sure why the ones I mentioned in particular are still missing from the list, because they were missing when I first looked at this, and they haven't seemed to have changed since then. Granted, they're not really very important protocols, otherwise they probably would be in the process of getting upstream, so maybe it's not that big of a deal, but when I use an application like this, I sort of expect it to have, you know, as much completeness as possible. Another thing missing is the cosmic stuff. Granted, this is only really, really new and hasn't really been available on things like Wayland Explorer for that long now. I think it got added to this page maybe like, I don't know, a couple of days ago. So I'd be very surprised if this was not added into the category here. If you're gonna have Chrome OS, obviously the cosmic stuff is gonna get listed as well. But then the question becomes, at what point do you actually stop? Because a lot of projects out there do have their own individual protocols that nobody else is using. A great example of this is Hyperland. Top level export, global key bindings, and focus grab. No other projects are using these protocols. So having them listed here, pretty much everything is gonna say unimplemented. Now, whilst that might also be the case in Chrome OS, some of these do actually get used in some other compositors. Same with the GameScope ones, and obviously the KDE ones. I'm on KDE, but some of these things are used in other things as well. A lot of the KDE stuff is fairly generic as opposed to being specifically what KDE wants. So as more compositors appear, there's going to be more and more of these like one-off protocols solving a problem that only that desktop has, or solving a problem in a way that only applies to that desktop. So do you go for absolute completeness or only go with the things that are listed as like big protocols on Wayland Explorer? I think, again, going for absolute completeness makes a lot more sense, but I guess ultimately it's up to the developer what they want to do here. If you're the kind of person that likes to jump around between different Wayland compositors and maybe try out applications that aren't necessarily built specifically for that environment, a great example of this being Grim and Slurp, the way that people often do screenshotting on WL Roots. This works great on WL Roots, but relies on a specific set of protocols that aren't necessarily going to be available everywhere. I believe GNOME is missing one of the protocols it needs. If you're doing that, if you like to play around with things, absolutely get this installed. It is going to make your life considerably easier. Yes, you can go and dig through the source code and dig through forums, try to work out why is this not working. This is a much easier way to go about doing it though. If you want to install it, it's available pretty much everywhere you want. Now, on slightly older versions of distros, you might see a slightly older version of the package. For the most part, it's going to work pretty much the same way. Maybe some protocols are missing, maybe the interface is a little bit different, but you're probably gonna be fine anyway. The developer of this application is a packager on Arch Linux, so that's pretty much always going to be up to date. Also, there is a Flatpak available. Now, I say that, but there's a very important caveat with the Flatpak. On the left-hand side is the regular version, on the right-hand side is the Flatpak. Now, ignore the fact that some things are in a slightly different order. If we order it like that, there we go. I don't know why some of them are being loaded in a different order. That's really weird to me. The main difference here, though, is in the Flatpak, it isn't going to know what compositor you are running. The screenshots here show it with the correct thing here, so either these are fake screenshots or screenshots of the non-Flatpak version, because I've never seen this actually report the compositor, and it shouldn't because it's sandboxed. Whilst having this with the GUI is certainly nice and useful, what I would like to see, and maybe this could be its own separate application, maybe it could just be a download thing in the application itself, a way to get a raw text dump of every single protocol supported, unsupported, all the protocols that are listed. Maybe have a CLI interface where you can easily go and parse through that data and things like that. I think if somebody's bored and wants to go and make something like that, all of the code base for this is available. You can go and examine it, look at how the protocol checks are being done, and then building a CLI interface around that wouldn't really be that much extra work. I don't know. Maybe if I'm bored, I'll go and do that myself. It sounds like a fun project to learn. But for now, let me know your thoughts down below. Have you played with this app before? Obviously, it's not something you need every single day, but when you do need it, I think it is really useful just to have around on your system. So let me know your thoughts down below. And if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, and Liberapay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I am stumbling over my words so much more than I normally would. What is this?